The most breathtaking creations of nature on the planet are volcanoes. Some of history's most disastrous occurrences have been a result of their colossal force and unpredictable nature. Volcanic eruptions caused high fatality tolls before the invention of electronics and warning systems, occasionally burying entire communities in a matter of minutes. Let's look into the five volcanoes that have wreaked the most destruction in human history. Number 5. Anzan, Japan, 1792. In Japan, Mount Anzan is a symbol of catastrophe. The volcano caused the biggest eruption tragedy in Japanese history in 1792 when its dome rose and eventually collapsed, causing a catastrophic landslide and wave that killed roughly 15,000 people. In 1990, over 200 years later, Mount Anzan started to sputter once more. About 10,000 pyroclastic flows were observed on Anzan's flanks between 1991 and 1994, some of which were observed up to 5.5 kilometers, 3.4 miles from the dome. In Shimabara City, which is located under the volcano, more than 2,000 houses had been damaged by these scorching ash and gas surges by summer 1993. Regardless of its reputation for devastation, Mount Anzan's natural beauty was acknowledged in 1934 and it became a part of Anzan-Amakusa National Park, one of the first national parks in Japan. The azaleas that blanket Anzan slopes in the spring are pink, and the mountain's summers are cool and lush. Due to its high altitude, Mount Anzan is also one of Kyushu's few locations to see the height of autumn colors, which typically occurs from late October to mid-November. Number 4. Nevado de Ruiz, Colombia, 1985. Like Mount St. Helens and Mount Rainier in Washington, Nevado de Ruiz is a large stratovolcano that rises above sea level to a height of more than 5,300 meters and is capped by glaciers. It is one of the northernmost volcanoes in the Andean volcanic belt, a band of volcanoes that runs along South America's western coast. The name Nevado means snow-capped. In the Los Nevados National Park, which also contains seven other volcanoes, is the second highest volcano in Colombia. Ruiz, Nevado de Ruiz, a volcano located about 130 kilometers from Bogota, the capital city of Colombia, erupted on November 13, 1985. Just a little after 9 p.m. local time, sending a furious mixture of hot ash and lava into the atmosphere. A mudslide about 30 meters high raced across the countryside, many villages, and eventually the town of Amaro, where it killed 70% of the town's inhabitants less than 3 hours later. Altogether, these mud flows, also known as lahars, claimed the lives of over 23,000 people. Heat released three lahars, a mixture of rock, volcanic debris, mud, and water. Even though it wasn't a particularly significant eruption, the lahars were caused by a glacier covering the volcano melting its snow and ice. At a speed of 30 kilometers per hour, the lahars surged down the volcano's flanks, sweeping up everything in their way, including cars and trees, as well as silt and water from the rivers they followed. In the end, the lahars destroyed and buried the towns they left behind. Several more eruptions took place the next day. Number 3. Mount Peli, Martinique, 1902. The French island of Martinique, whose town of Saint-Pierre, which is tucked into its northwest coast, was dubbed the Paris of the Caribbean at the turn of the 20th century, because it had displaced Fort de France as the colony's official capital and replaced it as its cultural hub. Ships hold precious loads of rum and sugar from its bustling harbor. The fact that Saint-Pierre was located beneath a sizable volcano that presented a challenge. Just 7 kilometers from Saint-Pierre, Mount Peli, one of these volcanoes, towered nearly 1,400 meters above the city. It's smooth, lush slopes sagged into the water and were occasionally pierced by sharp, deep gashes. There is disagreement over what exactly occurred on May 8 Ascension Day. However, one thing is certain. Saint-Pierre was destroyed by an infernal blast of hot gas and volcanic debris in the space of a few brief minutes. Shortly after that, all but a few of its almost 30,000 inhabitants were dead, including the governor, who had traveled there with his family to calm the populace. The majority of the victims died from asphyxia and burns that seared their skin and lungs. Subsequent analyses based on burned wood produced temperature estimates showing the gas cloud was between 350 and 400 degrees Celsius. The explosion flattened the village, toppling enormous stone statues several meters from their perches and sparing just a few walls that were parallel to the blast, suggesting that the cloud's speed was greater than 100 meters per second. Saint-Pierre continued to burn for several days after that. Ships in the harbor sank and began to burn. Louis August Cyprus, a disaster survivor who later went on tour with the Bonner Man Bailey Circus, was discovered in a jail cell when rescuers eventually made it through the wreckage. Number 2. Mount Krakatoa, Indonesia, 1883. Krakatoa is an island in the Strait of Sunda, roughly halfway between Java and Sumatra. The settlement of Anja, which housed a lighthouse and signal station for the numerous vessels traversing the strait, was located 26 miles to the south and west. Krakatoa was only a tiny, deserted island, measuring roughly 5 miles long and 3 miles broad. It had two summits, the higher of which was known as the Peak of Krakatoa and climbed 2,750 feet above the ocean. Volcanic cones can be seen on the nearby terrain, some of which are active, some of which are dormant, and some of which are dead. A succession of explosions led to a massive eruption of Krakatoa on August 26, 1883. The island's northern two-thirds submerged, causing a sequence of lava, pumice, and ash flows, as well as enormous tsunami that wreaked havoc on nearby beaches. The events that started on August 2026 resulted in the deaths of about 36,000 people and the destruction of hundreds of coastal towns and villages for those who lived nearby. A 300,000-square-mile, 800,000-square-kilometer area was covered in ash after the most intense explosion, which shot ash 50 miles, 80 kilometers into the sky and kept the region in the dark for 2.5 days. Around the world, the ash floated, creating halos around the moon and sun. Likewise, the ash served as a solar radiation screen, which decreased world temperatures in the year following the eruption by as much as 0.5 degrees Celsius, 0.9 degrees Fahrenheit. The next time temperatures were normal was in 1888, which was 5 years later. Number 1. Mount Tambora, Indonesia, 1815. Mount Tambora is an active stratovolcano that, before its eruption, was among the tallest mountains in all of Indonesia. Sumbawa, an island off the coast of Indonesia, saw the biggest volcanic explosion to hit the modern era on April 10, 1815. This event serves as a sobering illustration of a global climatic catastrophe. After the incident, it rose from 14,100 feet to just below 10,000 feet. The Tambora eruption was the greatest in the previous millennium. Tambora receives a 7 out of 8 on the US Geological Survey's Volcano Explosivity Index. That is 10 times larger than the Mount Pinatubo eruption in 1991 and 100 times more potent than the Mount St. Helens explosion in 1981. The immediate incident on the island resulted in the deaths of at least 10,000 people and potentially as many as 90,000. Mostly as a result of exposure to the pyroclastic flows, which are toxic, searingly hot waves of gas and rock that fell from the mountain. However, the consequences of Tambora were felt even further afield. About 100 megatons of sulfur aerosols were released during the eruption into the stratosphere, causing a gaseous surge that later turned into a global haze. Nowadays, in order to keep track of volcanoes, scientists employ a wide range of methods, such as seismographic detection of the earthquakes and tremor that almost always precede eruptions, exact measurements of the ground deformation that frequently occurs in conjunction with magma rise, changes in volcanic gas emissions, and changes in gravity and magnetic fields. But these are infamously inaccurate for two reasons. One, some volcanoes are adequately thoroughly researched to give a precise eruptive history over the many hundreds or tens of thousands of years needed for determining a valid recurrence interval. And too few volcanoes keep the same behavior for long. And that ends today's episode. What do you think of this episode? Please subscribe to Weather Collapse if you want to know more and be updated on the latest news about natural calamities or disasters happening all over the world. And don't forget to like today's video. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.